कितनी बार बोला है कि इतना तेल नहीं डालना है. You know, I have this big problem with people who tell me that Indian food cannot be healthy. So I used to weigh 95 kgs when I was 18, and it would really frustrate me. You know, one of my front office teachers in college said that why can't you be one of those first chefs who are not chubby, who don't have a pot belly? So the only way to change that was for it to test on myself. I really wanted to cook healthy food, but then I realized that charity has to begin at home. So it has to start with me, and only then can I change this world one meal at a time. You know, I believe food is something that can truly, really make you happy because it leaves a memory. Memory of taste and smell is something you will never forget. I love traveling. If I had to be anything else apart from a chef, I would be a traveler. When I go to Kunal, I take some inspiration from my own past. So I believe that after this tough journey where Kunal is going to hate me for a couple of weeks, but by the end of it, he's going to come back and say a thank you.
सारा गार्लिक
रॉ पपाया सैलेड साउंड्स फैंटास्टिक. नैटली ईट सी फूड सो फिश हैज टू बी फॉर हर. हुसैन डज नॉट लाइक एनी अदर मीट अपार्ट फ्रॉम चिकन. सो गाइस 30 मिनट्स द डिनर विल बी रेडी.
शुड वी डिनर?
नहीं यार, वो बोल रहा है 30 मिनट्स. आई थिंक वी शुड वेट.
यार वो बोलता है 30 मिनट्स, बट डेढ़ घंटे जरूर लगेगा.
मुझे तो बहुत भूख लगी है गिरीश.
मे बी दिस विल हेल्प. बर्गर.
Oh. Food for me is a source of happiness, a lot of happiness. I believe that people will never remember what they have eaten, but they will always remember how it made them feel. And I want them to feel happiness after eating something that I've cooked.
It was their idea.
They started it.
Yep, I told these guys the food will be ready in 30 minutes. Nobody listens to me.
This is usually my undoing, where I try and make something to keep everybody happy. I just believe that my passion for cooking will be reciprocated by patience for waiting. Maybe I'm wrong, and this bothers me. Happiness is not the only thing that's important to me. Health is also very important. Kunal and our many other Indians, with their new urban lifestyles and their bad eating habits, are staring down an epidemic called diabetes. In fact, India is already known as the diabetic capital of the world. Statistics show that diabetes has increased by an alarming percentage in the last 10 years and will continue to do so if something isn't done immediately. And as a chef, I feel this is what I can try and help fix this problem. And what better place to learn how to fix this problem than in Majuli. Majuli is not only the world's biggest delta island, but also a home to the Vaishnavites and the Mishing tribe. Both of them have their own cultural fabric as well as unique cooking methods. On few days, you know, we are all lucky. We also meet people who share equal amounts of passion towards food. And that's what Dilip Da on this trip has done for me. He is an expert in the Northeastern cuisine, especially the tribal side of the cuisine. And it's amazing how he has these healthy tips and tricks in his sleeves that are going to add so much more value to the dishes I cooked. Oh, okay.
I thought it's a little strong.
अरे यार, कम से कम भर तो दो. इतना सा क्या होगा? यार ये हुई ना बात.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
I would like to believe that Northeastern food is generally much more healthier than all cuisine all across India.
Yes, that is 100% true what you have heard. You don't spend money on oil. We don't add these oil and other things.
So I run a restaurant in Bombay called Goela Butter Chicken. मैं वहाँ पे जब लोगों को butter chicken serve करता हूँ, I made a healthier version.
हाँ.
In which I said I am adding no cream.
That's good.
And I add half the butter of the original recipe.
Yeah, yeah.
But as soon as I tell people that I am serving you butter chicken, which is Without. Healthier, they are afraid. So it's very strange.
Yeah,
they like it.
Same.
They find it tasty. But if I tell them it's healthy, they run away.
You know, you have to make a start somewhere. Slowly you'll see that they'll come running back to you. Ki wahi acha hai.
Every dish requires 10 to 12 dry spices. Every dish needs to have oil or needs to have some kind of fat. If I cooked like this for anybody back in Bombay, they'll be like, "Isko khana banana nahi aata." Mujhe bhi thoda sa lag raha hai ki yaar ye to kuch daal hi nahi rahe.
Theek hai, bana ke khilaunga na main. Main aise nahi bol raha hu, bana ke khilaunga.
Not only did I learn oil-less cooking techniques from Dilipda, but I also learned something that the girls who are traveling with me would be very excited about. Pallavi, you know, Dilipda was telling me that all the ladies in the Northeast have this glowing skin which never cracks. It never cracks.
Tell us now.
Dilipda, basically like a. These are the benefits of food which you have without oil. You know, it's natural oil.
That's something similar to what you do with your Goela's butter chicken, is that correct?
Wow, I like it. Remember all these things. Not bad.
This evening just set it up very nicely. Good food, good music, good drinks, good company. That's what life is all about anyway. So I think it was a very special moment on the journey.
Does this technique work for the vegetarians as well?
You know, it's that abe yaar moment where you know everything is perfect, but nothing is really ever perfect. I don't get it. Like, how do you make everybody happy? Like, why can't there be a day in a restaurant or outside where everybody is just happy with that one dish or that one meal? Food is one task, but to make them believe in it as a concept, as a lifestyle choice, is another. I'm learning that it's nearly impossible to keep everybody happy. And the only solace that I get is that I am not the only one who feels this way. Chacha Jan is a 70-year-old kebabier who comes from this generation of cooks who've been cooking kebabs and tikkas in that lane for 50 years, 5 decades. So it's going to be very interesting to kind of get an idea of how does he try and make his kebabs healthier. It's pretty surprising and unheard of. So Chacha Jan, ye achanak se healthy kebab ka idea kahan se aaya?
Hum itne saalon se bana rahe the, hamare gaak aane band ho gaye.
Aise kyun aane band ho gaye?
Bhai wo guzar gaye.
मतलब गुजर गए. I think it's pretty cute of him to think that his clientele, you know, has kind of died or washed away because of the kebabs that he cooked. But there's a big gap between us, both generation-wise and the way we treat food. But I think we share the same grief, and because of that, we have common beliefs.
हाँ
वहाँ पे तो बड़ी लाइन लग रही है, अपने यहाँ पे खाली क्यों है?
इनको जो चाहिए मसाला चीज, मिर्ची चीज।
तो क्या हमें ये करना चाहिए कि लोगों को खिलाए तो हेल्दी, पर उनको बताए नहीं की हेल्दी?
बताए नहीं, खिलाए हेल्दी, बताए नहीं उनको।
मैं आज खाता हूँ पहले आपके कबाब, अपने आप बिकेंगे। एक बात माननी पड़ेगी जाजान, तेल का नामो निशान नहीं है, मसाले बिल्कुल बराबर हैं, फ्लेवर बिल्कुल परफेक्ट है, मानना पड़ेगा। बात चाचा जान, मजा आ गया।
निकालिए फिर हमारे साथ रुपया।
और उसके ऊपर 20 रुपए रुमाली के। Oh, great.
You know, Saransh, I think you're not able to make all of us happy because you have people who live to eat. I think you should also meet people who eat to live.
I think that the Indian food never can be made healthy. You know? I mean,
नहीं कुणाल, अभी the trip has just started. We will make it healthy. Myanmar, for me, is strikingly beautiful. Every time I think of Myanmar, I think of the sunrise that I saw in Bagan, which does not leave. It looks like you are in a world which is backdated, which might not sound exciting, but when you see it, you kind of get lost in it.
And this serenity gave me time to think that what if there is nothing wrong with people's mindsets? Rather, there is something wrong with the balance in my food. Now I have to dig deeper and find the answer for myself.
So I'm sure everybody understands the concept of bhiksha. It's not alien to India, but we don't practice it anymore the way they still religiously practice it in Myanmar. You understand that food is still a very simple form of humanity. If you look at the interaction between these people,
they're just exchanging food.
And that bonds these people together, the community and the monks.
Said the child who around the 10 years.
Since she was 10, she's been
Yes.
It's difficult to explain how I felt because she had a very simple answer. I am doing this because it gives me a lot of happiness. I feel that this food is going to get me goodwill, and by cooking this food for somebody, I'm also providing them with a lot of goodwill. So it's like an exchange between the community. One of the nicest parts of that morning was that the monks came back with me in my S-Cross to the monastery, and I got to go to their kitchen. I was feeling a little more confident and cook a nice meal for monks because they're not restrictive to any kind of meat. They are accepting of whatever you cook for them.
While we've been preparing food, I saw you soaking in some aromas of
yes.
Myanmar.
Yes.
You were enjoying it there. Suddenly you seem like you're not enjoying those flavors. What's happening, Kunal? Like,
I'm surely enjoying it. It's just that dad ko yaad kar raha hu bahut, so.
Oh, why is that?
Because my dad was born in then Burma, now Myanmar, in the Shan state. And he spent his early childhood here.
Why are you telling this to me after like 2 days of coming to Myanmar? Like, we should have asked him for some food references.
He misses his childhood recipes, the flavors on which he was grown up here. And flavor is something which connects you to your childhood, you know, makes you remind of those days. So if I can learn these dishes from you, the ingredients and these flavors, if I can take it back to India, so I can probably bring back the childhood days in a flash for my dad. So
this is probably the best gift that you can take back from
him. Yeah, man. Absolutely. I think.
You know, I kind of felt satisfied to be able to have cooked for them and then served them. I was anxious while I was feeding the head monk specially. This is that one opportunity you get in your lifetime where you get to cook food for people from where you get blessings and you get positivity out of. So I just wanted to feel happy. And I think before I felt happy, I had to feel anxious. In this whole journey, the burning question for me has been, how do I keep a balance of my food with health and at the same time, I keep people happy. And while looking for this question, I reach this junction on my trip where I meet this perfect person who can give me the answer that I'm looking for.
Champion, I love cooking and I love feeding people. I love serving them. But it's very difficult to make everybody happy. Is there a way that, you could make everybody happy?
When the monk answered this question for me, it totally threw me off because I wasn't expecting somebody to tell me that this is not the right thing that you're looking for. You're already cooking and feeding people. What you need to do is, you need to ask a reverse question, are you happy?
I'm trying to find some balance in my food, in my style of cooking, in serving people. Is there anything that they say in Buddhism about that?
What I understood from his talks was that food does mean mind, body and soul, because for mind, it does not make it restless, and for body, it gives it the right nutrition, and for soul, it gives you a lot of happiness because you're eating food that keeps you happy. So that kind of completes the circle. What I felt more confident about was that the fact that this wasn't a problem with my food, it was a problem with my approach, made me much more confident. I felt that I could connect with people around me in a different light because I didn't have this fear of my food failing anymore. That need of being accepted by everybody is suddenly gone. And with this newfound approach and plan, hopefully, I will finally get that answer, I've taken this journey for. After meeting the monk, I realized that there's nothing wrong with my food. That I am probably looking in the wrong direction. I've been questioning my cooking techniques, methods, which is not really the case. So I think I kind of devised this amazing plan where I was certain that everybody will fall for it because in hindsight, there is something else hidden.
Yeah, the water level is too low. I doubt if there'll be any rapids ahead. I don't think anyone's gonna have fun.
Bhook bhi laga yaar, I'm hungry yaar.
You know what, guys? I think I have a perfect solution for both the fun and the food. This is the food. Okay. Everybody, keep their hands away from the table.
Okay.
So there's a condition on which you will get to eat this food. It's going to be a competition. It's going to be all of you against me.
But what if we lose?
Oh, yeah. Of course. There's always somebody who loses.
But what's the challenge?
So three contenders from the nine of you, which you guys pick, whoever wants to volunteer, are going to jump in the river one by one. And they have to race back to the boat, climb it, and I'm going to time you. Whoever out of those three people does it the quickest, I'm going to beat that time.
In your dream, bro.
We're beating for it, bro.
Hey, guys, but I think I'm going to be with you, man.
Hello. This challenge has been for you. Khana nahi milta. Abhi dekho, khana mil raha hai. Beat me and eat this food quietly.
Bro,
beat me.
Guys, you got to hear me out. After experiencing the healthy food, eating with the monks, helping you to cook for them, I finally realized that eating healthy is a way of life.
What really surprised me was how Kunal reacted to it. On that one day where the chances of them eating the junk are way more higher. And on that day, he's chosen to stick with me. So the fact that he's finally started to realize that healthy eating is supposed to be a lifestyle and not just about a snack or a salad, I feel glad. So, Kunal, well done. Okay, time for to go down. Jump!
Yeah.
After a lot of splashing, well, Natalie did fairly well. Hussain was okay. But Naved, by far, has to be the best one.
Naved has done 1 minute and 2 seconds. But, I'm going to saute you, deep fry you. I'm going to make sure that I do this under a minute.
Alrighty, are you sure? Are you ready?
Of course I'm ready.
Alrighty, time starts in 3, 2, 1.
Did work. So when they saw the food and when you told that this is cooked by me, how did they react to it?
When he smiles, he's a ray of sunshine. When he walks, he's got a kind of groove. When he speaks,
it was amazing because the expression, it's so cool, right? When they're, when people get so involved in eating, they stop talking, they stop looking anywhere else. They have this whole moment going on.
So food is happiness, right?
Yeah, food is happiness, and it, they all had this, you know, like if I had to talk in my social media terms, it was like food porn. Like all of them really going at it.
They believed in you?
Huh?
They believed in the story?
It was tough. They were like, no, he's trying to like walk out of this. Or he's trying to, you know, make a fool of us.
Did they buy in, finally?
They did buy in, absolutely.
Because of this Nexa journey, I got a fabulous opportunity to meet Chef Gagan Anand. Now this does not happen very often. And it was like the monk kind of sent me to Chef Gagan Anand. It's like one of those spiritual karmas, I guess. I think what I was looking for is what Chef Gagan Anand really gave me.
Don't sacrifice your happiness. The better you become, the more famous you become, the more critical people become, right?
Yes.
Yeah? I always take it that. You will make more enemies than friends.
But you still care, right, about people and what they have to say.
I can care up to the level that I understand is correct. I always believe that first make yourself happy. If you are happy, you will give your happiness to people around you. You have to be happy. You know, it's about that food. Yeah? You eat a dish, right? You feel happy. You eat a dish that's not tasty, you feel sad. You feel grumpy.
Yeah.
So food can make people happy and food can make people sad. If you're happy, you're growing up, butter chicken. And that is what makes you rich and famous. Do the butter chicken. Do it till you have the confidence and till you think that there are other
things. I'm ready to.
You can do whatever else you want. Yeah, evolve and.
I have realized that it is amazing to be wild. By wild, I don't mean going into the forest. By wild, I mean to just let it be. Be yourself. And people who kind of have been instrumental in teaching me that are Dilipda, for sure. Then Chef Gagan Anand, like how can he not be? But then the head monk, he sorted my path out. I realized that, you know what, I just have to kind of take it easy. And I have to believe in my art, believe in my craft, which is being a chef, and stand true to it. When you're away from your home, when you're away from your city, you have a lot of time to ponder and think. You have a lot of time to convince yourself that, yes, this is what I believe in. That is what Nexa Journeys has done for me. I've come back a much more confident chef.